Hello. I'm back again. And I just I made a few mistakes. I'm always making mistakes. I'm new with this. And I don't like to do do-overs. But I told you that I had a Facebook page and it was Ilana Kamisi L. It's actually Ilana Schamberger, but I do have on the yellow and pink glasses. So you can check out some of my posts on Facebook. You can friend me if you like. And before I get started, I just want to say that, my son asked me a long time ago. He was like, "Mama, how come we not normal like everybody else?" And it's like, the Lord have something special on my family, but that we don't get away with nothing. You know how other people can get away with doing stuff that they shouldn't be doing, not us. It's like we get reprimanded immediately. So we can't be normal in this world like everybody else. So we seem dysfunctional because the Lord is going to see to it that we all make it into the kingdom of heaven. I believe that's the blessing and the reason for the calling on our lives is that He uses us for an example, and it's like, what? Jeremy got his own place. What? And he doing a lot better than a whole lot of people, but he's supposed to be dysfunctional. You know what I'm saying? My oldest daughter, she's having a hard time. She's battling drug abuse, and as much as she's going through, she's still beautiful and standing. And my prayers go out to her. It really hurts my heart. And we all just all of my family, we all have our issues that we're dealing with because the Lord really has his hand on us, and we don't get to act like the rest of the world. But today, I'm gonna talk about I'm gonna come from Deuteronomy. There's some things I want to talk about in Deuteronomy. And I also want to let you know that we all have weapons. We all have powers. I mean, not even we have the power to step on scorpions. We have dominion over land and all fowl of the air. When you step into these things is when you start receiving the blessing from it. The power of prayer. If you're a child of God, the Lord hears your prayers. We have the power of binding. Whatever you bind here on earth, the Lord binds in heaven. So we can bind these demons. The power of loosing. Whatever we loose in heaven is loosed on this earth. So if you have treasures and if you know what all is up there, and I'm learning about those four ranks that I talked about in my last video, as far as Enoch going to heaven and telling the four cherubim to make a joyful noise to the Lord. Those ranks, you walk into your dominion. You overcoming evil. You gain your throne. You know what I'm saying? I'm talking about kings and queens, baby. We got a place in heaven, and the adversary don't want us to get back up there because he not getting back up there. Not that I know of. Now, the Lord do whatever. If he get back in there, he probably be the last one to get back in there. But he don't want to come to heaven. He want to be a god. So he gonna get to be a god of a lot of people that's not walking into their blessings from the Lord. So you have superpowers too, and they get more super as you walk into those general superpowers. Those are general superpowers that everybody can reach out and grab those. So I'm just gonna, my girl Lauryn Hill. I love her. And we're gonna check her out. And then I'm gonna get started. All
right. Like race fell on to third person, great things and demons, suffering worse, like human packages, high up in the streets, like we come from these kinds of things. Like race fell on, linked to denial, topics, survival, deafening silence, and social control. Like we just found an old wounds in the soul. When the door's light, when the leaves change, when I'm feeling sad, I simply remember all these kinds of things. And then I don't fear so bad. Like race founded, fed us a hatred. Like the bills, while we waited and waited, spirit of treason, this hatred and outrageous. Like races founded on these kinds of things. Like it's falling on, training and training, finding your freedom, stuck in the planning, finding your order while they say it's raining. Complaining.
Why they say it's raining, they poison us. These devils don't like us.
All of our democracy, training you. Why hate is falling on, blocking the truth. Why are you gone?
rage, but see, we all used to be one race, original man, and after the Tower of Babel is when we broke up into different nations, because as one we were just too powerful. The Lord was like, oh, they go, they can do anything they want to do, because you know we had became gods in the garden at that point. So and it's going to go back to that way again. What we're getting ready to find out is that we are all true Hebrew Israelites. But what I want to talk about is the lie today. The lie of white supremacy. There is no such thing, but it was allowed because of the disobedience of the original children of God. See, he loves us all. You know, that's why he sent Christ, so that the Jews and the Gentiles could get into heaven. And his only son, his only begotten son, he sent down here to die for us. so that we can all get into the kingdom of heaven, because we're all Hebrew Israelites. But the lie has been told about Black people. Black people don't know who they are. We don't know that we are that chosen group that God set aside only to show his glory. We the same group that could never get it right. So we that group that he had to show the world, okay, my special group don't want to obey me. Well, I'm going to send them into slavery. So, and fear for their lives every day. And they women will be raped. And they'll build houses and don't live in them. It's all there in Deuteronomy 28. And that's where I'm going to come from today. I also believe that the Black woman catch so much hell because she committed first sin. She was the one who indulged in the forbidden fruit. And before the Tower of Babel, the original people, the Sumerians, those were Black people. Those were Black people. Nimrod and his crew, they, all of them were Black people, you know. And I believe that there was a mitochondria Eve, and that that woman was a Black woman. And it looked like, you know, I know people say you wrong for saying that, but I mean, the Black woman is the one with that all the ghettoism, you know. She gotta have a fat behind, you know, her butt gotta be big. And then you got other nations of people that mimic that, and you know, the ghetto and, you know, hair weaves and, you know, all of this, this is stemming from the Black woman. This come from us. We are the leaders and the least of them, all in the same breath. It's cool to be Project Hood ghetto. Like, that's the coolest. If you know how to twerk, oh man, you the baddest. You know, things like that. It comes from us. It comes from us. So now, let me get started. It's quite a bit to read. And it's going to be Deuteronomy 28, 15 through 68. Okay. And this is the curse for disobedience. And you just tell me if this sound like you. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee. Cursed shall be the city, and cursed shall be the field. Cursed shall be the basket and thy store. Cursed shall be the fruit of thy body and the fruit of thy land, the increase of thy kin and the flocks of thy sheep. Cursed shall be when thou comest in, and cursed shall be when thou goest out. The Lord shall send upon the cursing vexation and rebuke in all that thou settest thine hand unto for to do, until thou be destroyed and until thou perish quickly because of the wickedness of thy doings, whereby thou hast forsaken me. The Lord shall make the penitence cleave unto thee. The Lord shall make the pestilence cleave unto thee until he have consumed thee from off the land, whether thou goest to possess it. The Lord shall smite thee with consumption and with a fever and with an inflammation and with an extreme burning and with the sword and with blasting and with mildew. And they shall pursue thee until thou perish. And thy heaven that is over thy head shall be brass, and the earth that is under their feet be iron. The Lord shall make the rain of thy land powder and dust. From heaven shall it come down upon thee until thou be destroyed. The Lord shall cause thee to be smitten before thine enemies. Thou shalt go out one way against them and flee seven ways before them, and shall be removed into all the kingdoms of the earth. And thy carcass shall be meat unto all fowls of the air and unto the beasts of the earth. And no man shall fray them away. The Lord will smite thee with the botch of Egypt, and with the emrods, and with the scab, and with the itch where thou canst not be healed. The Lord shall smite thee with madness and blindness and astonishment of heart, and thou shalt grope at noonday as the blind gropeth in darkness, and thou shalt not prosper in thy ways, and thou shalt be only oppressed and spoiled evermore, and no man shall save thee. Thou shalt betroth a wife, and another man shall lie with her. Thou shalt build a house, and thou shalt not dwell therein. Thou shalt plant a vineyard, and shalt not gather the grapes thereof. Thine ox shall be slain before thine eyes, and thou shalt not eat thereof. Thine ass shall be violently taken away from before thy face, and shall not be restored to thee. Thy sheep shall be given unto thine enemies, and thou shalt have none to rescue them. Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people, and thy eyes shall look and fail with longing for them all the day long. And there shall be no might in thy land. The fruit of thy land and all thy labor shall a nation which thou knowest not eat up. The fruit of the land and all thy labors shall a nation which thou knowest not eat up. And thou shalt be only oppressed and crushed always. Oppressed and crushed always. So that thou shalt be mad. Shall be mad for the sight of thine eyes, which thou shalt see. Just mad. Just upset. Y'all was, why black men can't get what? The Lord shall smite thee in the knees and in the legs with a sore botch that cannot be healed, from the sole of thy foot unto the top of thy head. The Lord shall bring thee and thy king, which thou shalt set over thee, unto a nation which neither thou nor thy fathers have known. America sound like. And there shalt thou serve other gods, wood and stone. Nothing like that cross you see all the time up in the church. And thou shalt become an astonishment, a proverb, and a byword among all nations whither the Lord shall lead thee. thou shalt carry much seed out into the field, and shalt gather but little in, for the locust shall consume it. Thou shalt plant vineyards and dress them, but shalt neither drink of the wine nor gather the grapes, for the worm shall eat them. Who the locusts and the worms here? Thou shalt have olive trees throughout all thy coast, but thou shalt not anoint thyself with the oil, for thine olive oil shall cast his fruit. Must not be making oil. Thou shalt begat sons and daughters, but thou shalt not enjoy them, for they shall go into captivity. And how many times women had children and they got sold off to another family and they never saw those children again. The stranger that is within thee shall get up above the very high, and thou shalt come down very low. So the stranger that is above thee is going to prosper. He's going to be the man on top. Our plantation owner, our master, he was above thee. And he bought us very, very low. He shall lend to thee, and thou shalt not lend to him. He shall be the head, and thou shalt be the tail. Moreover, all these curses shall come upon thee, and shall pursue thee, and overtake thee, till thou be destroyed, because thou hearkenest not unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to keep his commandments and his statutes which he commanded thee. And they shall be upon thee for a sign and for a wonder, and upon thy seed forever. And people look at black people and they be like, oh, how did they make it through all? Oh, wow. And in all of that, he gave us so much strength. So much strength. A lot of athleticism. We can leap tall buildings in a single bound. Just a joke. Because thou servest not the Lord thy God with joyfulness and with gladness of heart, for the abundance of all things. See, David danced up out his clothes, baby. Woo! He was full of joy from the Lord. I get that way sometimes. I get so happy. I be like, when I get up in heaven, I'm gonna be high-fiving. People tell me, yeah, we made it. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm gonna get up in there and cut up. And it just makes me happy. Therefore shall thou serve thine enemies, which the Lord shall send against thee in hunger and in thirst and in nakedness and in want of all things. We ain't hardly have clothes on half the doggone time. Couldn't bathe, was stinking, didn't have no water. Had to eat the swine, had to eat the chickens off the pig, because we couldn't eat none of that oxen and them sheep they was out there killing. We could kill it. We couldn't eat none of it. We ain't getting none. We was doing bad, baby. And in want of all things. This is a curse. We cursed. And he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck. Oh, you know what a yoke is. That big old heavy metal piece they put on the oxen. The dried oxens. A yoke of iron. That was a heavy yoke. It was chains up on our necks. How many of us can see us to picture that? That's a vivid picture. Until he have destroyed thee, the Lord shall bring a nation against thee from far, from the end of the earth, As swift as the eagle flieth, a nation whose tongue thou shalt not understand. When we came over here, we did not understand no English. We didn't know what they were saying to us. A nation of fierce countenance, which shall not regard the person of the old, nor show favor to the young. But they ain't have no respect for us. And he shall eat the fruit of thy cattle and the fruit of thy land until he destroys it. So they went, a lot of them, they went back over there after they got all the slaves that they could, which was the true Hebrew Israelites, God's chosen group. Because they was grabbing up some black people that weren't supposed to be, you know, not everybody over in Africa or in that part of the country was under the curse. Just this chosen group. So 9 times out of 10, if you was born in America, then your people came over on that boat. A lot of people don't want to accept that. Oh, it was black people here in America before slavery. I don't know about all that. I know what's in this Bible. And I know if we here, 9 times out of 10, our ancestors was this chosen group. It was part of this chosen group. I don't know if all the 12 tribes of Israel fell up under that curse, or was it just one tribe that fell up under the curse? Sometimes doing these things just bring about more questions, but the Lord seems to always answer them. So I be careful about asking these questions, because sometimes the answer can really blow my mind. We almost done. And the fruit of thy land until thou be destroyed, which also shall not leave thee either corn, wine, or oil, or the increase of thy kin, or flocks of thy sheep, increase of thy kind, or flocks of thy sheep, until he have destroyed thee. And he shall besiege thee in all thy gates, until thy high and fenced walls come down, wherein thou trusted throughout all the land. And he shall besiege thee in all thy gates throughout all thy land, which the Lord thy God have given thee. Oh, but what I was saying was they went back over there after they got the slaves, and then they raped the lands. They took all of the diamonds. They took all of the treasures out of the land too. They see the land was fruitful too. So they got all of that. And thou shalt eat the fruit of thy own body, the flesh of thy sons and of thy daughters, which the Lord thy God have given thee, in the siege and in the straitness, wherewith thine enemies shall distress thee. And what I think they mean by that is that it's a song that go, America eats their young, number 9 on the, and it's not saying that they physically are eating their young. They're saying spiritually they eating their young, you know, because they sacrificing their young up, because they bowing to the devil, because they distressed. They don't know what else to do. If they in a land that it's a bunch of confusion going on right here, right now. Okay. A lot of it. Mind blowing confusion. So that the man that is tender among you and very delicate, his eyes shall be evil towards his brother and toward the wife of his bosom and toward the remnant of his children, which he shall leave, taking the father from the children, so that he will not give to any of them of the flesh of his children whom he shall eat, because he hath nothing left him in the siege and in the straitness, wherewith thine enemy shall distress thee in all thy gates. And see, I think I read about the gates in Nehemiah, It's a sheep gate. It's a water gate. It's a oh my goodness, what is our fish gate? It's quite a few of them. I was trying to remember them all, but you can go to Nehemiah and read about those gates. See, all they gates have been violated. The tender and delicate woman among you, which would not adventure to set the sole of her foot upon the ground for delicateness and tenderness, her eyes shall be evil toward the husband of her bosom and toward her son and towards her daughter. So see, evil taking over. These people is distressed. Evil taking over the husband, evil taking over the wife. Yeah, evil gonna jump in the children because they parents is evil towards them. And toward her young one that cometh out from between her feet and toward her children, which she shall bear, for she shall eat them for want of all things secretly in the siege and straightness. Now she's trying to straighten this crooked path. And so, you know, slave master might say, you know, she might think, you know, if she sleep with the slave master, she gonna get some special privileges. You know, this is gonna get right. She sleep with massa. For she shall eat them for want of all things secretly in the siege and straightness, wherewith thine enemy shall distress thee in all thy gates. If thou would not observe to do all the words of this law that are written in this book, that thou mayest fear this glorious and fearful name, the Lord thy God. You're going to be scared of him. You're going to tremble. I tremble anyway. I fear the Lord. Then the Lord will make thy plagues wonderful, and the plagues of thy seed, even greater plagues, and of long continuance, and sore sicknesses, and of long continuance. Moreover, he will bring upon thee all the diseases of Egypt. You know what he did when Moses, he said, told Moses, set the people free, and they didn't. So he bought all them plagues. So we're going to get all the diseases of Egypt, which thou wast afraid of, and they shall cleave unto thee. Also every sickness and every plague which is not written in the book of this law, then will the Lord bring upon thee until thou be destroyed. And ye shall be left few in number. So they was killing us off. Either sickness was killing them, or disease was killing them, or they was getting lynched or burnt or hung or something. Whereas ye were as the stars of heaven, it was a bunch of us, for multitude, because thou wouldest not obey the voice of the Lord thy God. And it shall come to pass that as the Lord rejoiced over you to do you good and to multiply you, so the Lord will rejoice over you to destroy you and to bring you to naught, and ye shall be plucked from off the land whither thou goest to possess it. And the Lord shall scatter thee among all people, from the one end of the earth even unto the other, and there thou shalt serve other gods, which neither thou nor thy fathers have known, even wood and stone. It's a whole new set of gods. And among these nations shalt thou find no ease, neither shall the sole of thy foot have rest, but the Lord shall give thee there a trembling heart, and failing of eyes, and sorrow of mind, and thy life shall hang in doubt before thee, and thou shalt fear thy day and night, and shall have none assurance of thy life. In the morning thou shalt say, would God it were even. And at even thou shalt say, with God it were morning, for the fear of thine heart, wherewith thou shalt fear, and for the sight of thine eyes, which thou shalt see. And the Lord shall bring thee unto Egypt again with ships by the way whereof I spake unto thee. Thou shalt see it no more again. And there ye shall be sold unto your enemies for bondmen and bondwomen, and no man shall buy you. So that's the curse of disobedience. And it must have been in my more modern day Bible where they break it down and they, you know, they say that your women will be raped. And maybe when I go back through the video, I can actually point it out and hear, you know. But this is the curse for disobedience amongst a certain group of people. And I don't see where that fits anybody, but so let's see. But guess what? We all are God's children. We all were one nation, Hebrew Israelites. And we all are one nation again. One nation under God, indivisible. One nation under the true and living God. See, we wanted to become, the adversary was having us to become one nation under him. And God wasn't having that. No, 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 no. He was not having that. But we are royalty. See, my show. Royalty. Kings and queens. Royal. Those commercials, they're always popping up.
Royalty. Royalty. How is it chosen people? Bible in my hand, the word inside my heart, and pain before my eyes. Broken people wanting to believe in something, looking for a light, trying to find the truth. But we give them God's name, we do something we done. Heard people say we do things that we want. Moving sheets, building with crossing the ships. Taking people money, promising to be blessed. How to the girls and people. Who at one point wasn't good as an evil. There's no chosen people. You're the priest. And that you've been pumped out of the country. Into the mountains. Do you know who you are? Royalty. Once we were the people, now we are the people. Do you know who you are? Royalty. 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 Kings and queens. Royalty. Royalty, yeah, give them. Would you let them call you those names if you knew you were for me? And my brother, would you be out there within your life of me? If you knew you had it all already, if you knew you were for me. Well, the best I can offer is to tell you the truth. Mercy changed everything for me and you. They don't really tell us what we do need to know. First Peter 2:6, special show. So power to the chosen people. Who and what was the beautiful people? It is not chosen people. A royal prince. Yeah. But you will fall down into the waters. Do you know who you are? Royalty.
Thank you.